there is one central point. And this central point is in one word, resumed in one word. It's the word transference. It's a very important word, Rafshat. I've talked years about it. Transference is keeping the differences. We are all different, isn't it? I hope so. So there are differences between people, between groups of people, between religions, but a miracle can happen. And the miracle is that there is trans-difference, that there is a possibility of bridging between the religions. If that possibility is realized, then this could prepare a more peaceful society in which cooperation between people becomes possible. It's very important to do that. So it's not a luxus. It's not something which you can do. No, you must do it, certainly also in Europe. In Europe, when you have different religions and different people. So you have to develop it if you want to see religion as a part of culture. Religion as a Janus face, that I learned from José Casanova, whom I met in Berlin. And he said the religions can contribute to the civilization and they can destroy a civilization. We know in recent times, with Daesh, with ISIS, that there's destruction of civilization when it's killing the old people. We are, because they are robots. That's all. So in our fanatic times, we have to see that the religions have a Janus face. They can contribute for the good, they can contribute for the bad. It's why it's important to construct this theology, which is an interreligious theology.
Do you have an example that it had a good contribution to heaven?
Oh, yes, many. And I will give only one. I refer to it with Heschel. Heschel, as a prophetic philosopher, thought that he had to be connected with Martin Luther King, because he thought when these two religious leaders were going together, that it could bring a kind of revolution in America, a quiet revolution, not a peaceful revolution. And this is through the use of the Exodus motif. Let my people go, which was inherited